from time to time, we come up with clever ideas that we use on Canva to create amazing looking graphics. This is one of those very exciting videos where we're going to take a round shape and a rectangle and we're going to create this amazing spider with a spider web to create an amazing looking logo. Join me. Head over to canva.com, open a blank logo canvas or whatever canvas you want to use, and add a circle to your design. While the circle is selected, scroll down to gradients. There's a beautiful gradient brownish color that just represents a spider in my opinion. Make the shape smaller by squeezing it, representing the head of the spider, and then adjust it so that it looks like the head of your spider. Next, we're going to go back to our lines and shapes, and we're going to look for a triangle. We change the color to make it the same gradient color for the body of the spider. And then click on your lines to change the corner rounding of your rectangle to make it a bit rounded so that it looks like the body of the spider. And then reduce the size of your rectangle and add it to your head so that you have your spider. Next, head over to your lines and shapes to go and pick a rounded square or a square shape. Change the color to make it look like the spider. Once you've done that, you're going to be creating the horns of your spider and size it and make it a little bit smaller so that it looks like the horns of your spider. Then add it on the spider's head. Send it to the back of the head of the spider so it looks cohesive and it looks like a spider. And then head over to your elements, search for a line on your graphics, and then add this rugged looking line that's going to represent the arms and the legs of your spider, and change the color of this line shape and make it the brownish color and start getting to work to add the lines as the legs and the arms of your spider. Have fun with this. I certainly had fun with this one. I'm standing in the red inside a payphone. Just wanna break, no. I'm not gonna give in. Take a last shot, Michael J. Win. No, I'm not a robot, I'm in my own skin. Never get lost when thoughts pull you in. I miss the old you. We died with a purpose. All the energy around me felt nervous. Scared I would pop out fast to the surface. Had to cut it off before you made me worthless. Torn apart, I've been torn and scarred. I had a given art, but now I'm thinking smart. I'm keeping up my guard. I'm hiding every card. A royal flush of love. You never know what's hard. With a back to the mat, gonna see where I'm at. I'ma fight like I'm mad. I'ma be something that they can never be me. Nice try, but they'll see I achieve everything while they stay salty. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. That's it. Congratulations, you've got a spider. You've just created a spider. Reduce the size of your spider, make it a little bit smaller, put it on the side so that you start creating your spider web. Press L for line, or head over to your lines and shapes to edit line, and then change the border or the rounded endpoints, make them rounded. Make the size of your line weight like a little bit bigger. Size it and make it like a straight line. Duplicate that shape to have the upper part of your web, and reduce the size a little bit, and then add the five sides of your spider web. Then head over to your elements and look for a curved shape. Once you find your curved shape, rotate it and start building your spider web. Where it is necessary, duplicate the shape and make it two of them so that it makes it a bigger, bolder line of your web. And you just carry on like that, creating your web using the curved line all the way through until you have a spider web that looks like a spider web. Don't speak quietly, opinions violently thrown across.
me nervous. It's the world honestly burning, that's all I'm learning. Hope that we can make a turn and start reversing. All our minds, we put the work in, we got some work, man.
And that's it, you've got a spider, you've got a spider web. Tell me on the comments below, this was not fun. It is certainly fun for me. Then once you're done, you're going to group them and you're going to add your spider on top of your web. And then you're going to press T for text to add the name of the company for the logo that you are designing for. Send the spider to Beck if you want that kind of a design. So it's a designer choice. Once that's done, you are done with your 2D. One of the coolest things that you could do with Canva these days is to animate your graphics. We could animate this spider using the Create Animate that Canva released. So you're going to select your graphic and you're going to click on Animate so that it shows you the animation. Then you click on Create an Animation. And you can move it to wherever you want to move it, the way that you want to move it. And then you have a logo that animates. How cool is that? But that's it. We're done. Enough playing around. You can now download your 2D logo so that you can convert it to 3D. All you do, you click on share and then you go click on download. In order for you to have a cleaner, cooler looking logo, you would select SVG. Take note, this is only available for Canva Pro. The other question that I get is, what kind of software do I use? I use a MacBook. And if you want to go grab one of the MacBooks or any other software using my Amazon link, you can find it below on the software that I use. Then we're going to jump into Photopea, www.photopea.com, and we're going to select a template. I want to use a different template today because my son says he doesn't like the black one. We're going to grab the blue, gorgeous looking one, one that says logo mockup. You click on it and it loads. Then you're going to double click where it says your logo here. And then you're going to hide the example. Drag your 2D logo. We've downloaded it as an SVG from Canva, also available on Canva Pro. And then you click and you drag it and you size it on your canvas so that it's nice and big and fills the canvas itself. Once you're done, you're going to change your logo to a smart object. So you can press Command S or Control S on Windows and then it changes to smart object. And then you click the first tab and voila, you get your spider web and a spider logo looking very graphic and very gorgeous. I love it. Let me know your comments below what you think. If you would like to go and learn another shape logo that we did just using shape and it was a dress, go watch this video. I will see you on my next video.